Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to solve a new numerical which is based on WMAX itself, that is maximum work itself. So let us see what is the numerical and what are the requirements of it. So this is the numerical that they have provided to us, which says that 2.8 into 10 raised to minus 2 kg of nitrogen gas is expanded isothermally and reversibly at 300 Kelvin from 15.15 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square, and work done is found to be minus 17.33 kilojoule. So we have to find out that what would be the final pressure of it. So let us see that how can we extract the data from the question and find out the answer. So first of all, the given data that we could write it as, they have provided us the weight of nitrogen. So I could write it as W of N2, which is given as 2.8 into 10 raised to minus 2 kg. This can be converted into gram also. So I could convert it into gram as 2.8 into 10 raised to minus 2 into, instead of K, I would write as 10 raised to 3 gram. So this will give me an answer as 2.8 into 10 raised to, when minus 2 is multiplied by 10 raised to 3, then we'll get answer as 10 raised to 1 gram, which is nothing but 28 gram of nitrogen. And that of the molecular weight of nitrogen can be easily calculated as, where M of N2 is nothing but the molecular weight of nitrogen. In this case, the molecular weight of nitrogen is 14 for one nitrogen. So therefore for N2 it would be 14 plus 14, that is 32. Sorry, 14 plus 40, that is 28. So therefore the molecular weight of nitrogen is again 28 gram per mole. So in this case we have also got what is the weight of nitrogen and what is the molecular weight of nitrogen. Let us see what are the next data that they have provided us. They have said that the temperature that should be that is being maintained in this process is 300 Kelvin. So this is the temperature that they have been maintained, and the work done in this process is found to be, that is W, which is found to be work, and this is a maximum work that they have been provided, which is minus 17.33 kilojoules. So this kilojoules can be converted into joules also. So therefore eventually we will get the value of W max as minus 17.33 into 10 raised to 3 joules, as well as they have provided the pressure as the first pressure, that is the pressure P1, as 15.15 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square. So this is the value of the P1 that they have provided, and we have to calculate the final pressure, that is P2. So in this case, one thing has been clear, that we have to use the formula where the pressure is related with the Wmax. So there is a formula that we already know, that is Wmax is equals to minus 2.303 nRT log to the base 10 of P1 divided by P2. It is similar as the previous numerical that we have did, but instead of that there was volume, and now we are going to calculate what would be the pressure of it. So in this case the Wmax that they have been given to us is found to be minus 17.33 into 10 raised to 3 joules minus of 2.303 into the value of N. It is very easy to calculate because the weight of the nitrogen that they have provided is found to be 28, and that of the molecular weight of nitrogen is found to be 28 itself. So N would be W of N2 divided by molecular weight of N2, which is nothing but 28 divided by 28, that is 1. So in this case the value of N is 1 itself. So therefore N is equals to 1, and that of R is 8.314 into T. The temperature that they have provided us is 300 Kelvin, into, instead of knowing the value of P1, we'll still consider as log of P1 divided by P2. So now what we are going to do is, we are going to evaluate this thing and let us find out what will be the value of log of P1 divided by log of P2. So therefore, log of P1 divided by log of P2 will be, for a better instance, what I'll do is, I'll cancel out this minus signs. So now it would be very much easy for us. So this will be 17.33 into 10 raised to 3, the whole divided by 2.303 into 8.314 into 300. So let us see what is the answer that we could get here. So we have got the answer as 3.016. So this is the value of log of P1 divided by P2. But we are not done yet, because we have to calculate what is the pressure, what is the value of P2. So in this case, what I'm going to do is, I am shifting the value of log on that side. So this will be anti-log of 3.016. So the anti-log of 3.016 can be calculated as 1037.52, and now I could easily calculate what will be the value of P1 divided by P2, which is found to be 1037.52. And instead of this, I could easily substitute the value of the pressure that they have provided us is for the P1. So the P1 that they have provided to us is 15.15 into 10 raised to 5. That of P2 is 1037.52. So therefore, the value of P2 will be, I'll divide this thing by 1037.52, and let's see what is the answer that we could get. So this will be, found to be 1460.21. But this is pressure. So pressure are being measured in Newton per meter square, or are measured in Pascal. So therefore, this pressure can be calculated, because the initial pressure was being given as Newton per meter square. So therefore, this will be also be mentioned in Newton per meter square. So this is how we have calculated the pressure in Newton per meter square for a particular question. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood that how to calculate this kind of numerical. This is very much easy, and I hope you will try to solve this kind of numerical in your future too, and share this video with your friends and try to solve more and more kind of this kind of numericals. And thank you, and please don't forget to subscribe eGrad channel.